So now we are coming to the end of our first half two. Now we have to look back upon ourselves and try to find out what have we achieved out of this. We must understand that Sahaja Yoga is not done through brain activities. Like many people think that if you just tell yourself you have to be like this, it will work. If you have to all the time inform yourself that, oh, you must get rid of a particular problem, it will be all right. Or some people think that if they tell somebody that this is wrong with you and you should get well, it will be all right. It is not so. Because Sahaja Yoga does not work on mental level. It works on spiritual level, which is a much higher level than the mental level. So what you have to do is to understand how to correct your chakras. And you must understand how to work out your machines. Perhaps people still live on mental level and try to solve problems on mental level. And that's why all the problems start coming up. Now, if you have a problem with any chakras, or there is anything catching, or you find that there's something wrong, no use working it out on any other level but spiritual level. Some people believe that if they have dressed up like something, or if they outwardly behave like something, they become that. That is not true. Like we have hippies in the West, and they think that they have become primitive. You do not become primitive by believing into it. Because you are so overdeveloped that you cannot become primitive. So by just doing something mentally, we do not become. Now this mental level can go even further in a subtler way into people. Some of you might feel that by knowing some of the aartis and things by heart, you will achieve great, is not true also, because that is also just words. But if that is an awakened thing within you, then they become a mantra. And then you can work it out. But first of all, you must achieve a certain standard to have that power to create the mantras. Also, when you say samarthi, it's not necessarily possible that it will work out. Let us face the things as they are and not to be conditioned by anything else. You have to achieve a certain depth within yourself to even to enlighten the mantra. First of all, you should have clear-cut vibrations, minimum of minimum. If you have certain chakras catching, then try to improve your chakras with the photograph. With all due respect to the photograph, it's only the photograph which is going to work it out, nothing else. Or if I'm there. But once you have achieved a certain state of enlightenment, then you can use mantras, otherwise also it will help. But first of all, your heart must be clear. I have found out in general there are two chakras overwhelmingly not working all right in most of the Western people. First is the heart. That means heart is not clear. That heart is not clean. That in the heart you still are a small person. In the heart you have not placed your mother. You have to purify your heart by looking at the photograph and putting all loving feelings about your mother, understanding her work and putting her into your heart. If the heart is not clear, then everything has no meaning because it is a dark heart which is doing all these things. The heart has to be clean, absolutely surrendered, and must try to put me before everything else. I can tell you because you are all Sahayogis. I cannot say this to people who are not Sahayogis. Now, we always try to relate Sahayoga from our own terms, not from the terms that belong to God. God is what He is. He cannot change Himself. You have to change. So whatever we think about God, we want to put on that. For example, if someone thinks that he tries to be nice or good to me, or if he is close to me, so-called, and if he thinks he is organizing better or he is doing this work or that work, or anything else like that, where he feels that he is important because he is doing this job or that job, then one must know that all this is mental. Actually, you are doing nothing. Whenever you try to do something, you really confuse yourself and confuse me also. You have seen yesterday's example. I was sure that they had to go next day, but nobody would listen to me and they rushed away and they found that the tickets were for the next day. This knowledge comes to you if you are clear-hearted. As yesterday I said, you better not come. I didn't know what was the situation there. I just said, don't come. Finished. Because I knew what was going to happen. So this clear-cut idea comes to you when your heart is clean. But first of all, people do not understand that you have to work it through your heart and not through your brain. When we have to work out things through our brain, we try to develop our brain, isn't it? By memorizing, by practicing something, teaching our brain how to think, how to go this way, that way, we try to train our brain. Now we have to train our heart in Sahayoga. And to train our heart in Sahayoga, one has to know first of all that it is enveloped either by ego or by superego. The limbic area actually represents the heart. And if there is ego, heart will always be so-called. It will not be the real heart that will be working, but it's only mental projection. And you will feel that I'm doing it from my heart. That's not true. Now then, supposing what should we do if we have ego? You might say you should try to sort of tell yourself that that's not good and this and that and all kinds of mental suggestions or auto-suggestions or this, the way psychiatrists and all that give you suggestions. That's again mental. So that's not the way it is going to work out. We must understand that for that what we have to do is to raise the left side and put it to the right side. There's no other way out. You have to just work it out with your hands. Your hands are working it out and not your brain. So use your hands and the methods of Sahayoga. Now, everyone must have a regular sitting in the water every day. That's important. Every morning you must do your meditation. Because on mental level we feel we have been with Mother, all right. This exposure is all right. You came, you saw how Indians are and how they are light on their feet and how they are good for Sahayoga. But after seeing all that, you have to know that Sahayoga is to be worked out, is not to be thought out. You just cannot think about it. Whatever you may try to do through your thought, you cannot achieve any results in Sahayoga. You have to use your hands, you have to use your feet, you have to soak your feet in the water because water is the ocean. All these five chakras, or say six chakras, which are, I say five, because the one is the Muladhara chakra, which is the seventh, and the topmost is the brain. So in between five chakras, which are there, are to be handled fully with the idea that they are basically made of matter. And these five elements constitute the body of these chakras. Now these chakras, if they are to be corrected, we have to correct them by taking out all the problems of these chakras into the elements from which they come. For example, a person who is a very right-sided person, so he has to give a balance by the left side. Of course, raising with the hand is all right, but what about the element? Right-sided person has all the elements which give heat. You can say the light, we can say the fire. So for people who are right-sided, the light is not going to help much. Like if you put the light before the photograph, and those who are ego-oriented people, if you just use the light, it's not going to work out. So what is going to work out is the Mother Earth and the water element, which is cooling. Even ice is very helpful to people who are right-sided. So all cooling effects should be used for correcting your right-sidedness, so that you cool it down. Same about food. In food, those who are right-sided people should take to foods which are left-sided, that is carbohydrates, means they should become partly vegetarians or quite a lot of vegetarians, and should eat things at the most like chicken, but not fishes, not seafoods, because they are all hot. That's how you treat your material side of your chakras. Now the left-sided people should use again the dipa, means the light, or the fire, to correct their left side. Also in food, such people should take more to nitrogenous, means protein, and foods like that. They should take more proteins. Now, as far as Sahaja Yoga is concerned, the basic thing is Kundalini. And the Kundalini, as I have told you, is the pure desire. Again, listen to it carefully, pure desire. That means all other desires are impure. There's only one pure desire, and that is to be one with the Divine, one with the Brahma, one with God. That's the only pure desire. All other desires are impure. So train your mind gradually to achieve that desire as the main thing. If you train your mind in that fashion, then you can develop pure desire. So all other desires will negate gradually. All right. Now this desire to be one with the Divine is the purest and the highest. And to achieve that, what have you to do? To achieve that, you have to keep your mother pleased. Very simple. Adi Shankaracharya has said that you don't bother about anything, just keep your mother pleased. You have to be a simple person, not try to be cunning with me or clever with me. I know everyone very well. Try to tell yourself that I should say things I should behave in a manner that will please my mother. Supposing you are in Sahaja Yoga and you are doing wrong things, it is not going to please me at all. So, how to please mother, that you should try to see for yourself. What kind of a thing pleases me the best? I am also a very simple person. So I want a simple-hearted person. Who is simple-hearted? For example, a person who tries to show off too much, try to be always the first, or try to be always the sort of a cinema star. I don't like such people. You have to be very quiet and extremely shy about showing off yourself. Do I show off that I am Adi Shakti? I do not. I live like you, absolutely like you. Do I try to show off? Then why should you try to show off to me? So that kind of a person is no good. Secondly, you should not be tense with me. There is no need to be tense. If I find something wrong with you, if I scold you also, it's for your good. If I say a good word, it is for your good. My Sahaja Yoga works this way. I have no malice against anyone in the whole world, no malice at all, and no anger for anyone in this world. I have nothing but compassion. But in compassion, sometimes I have to scold, and in the same compassion, I have to speak in a very compassionate manner. So, both ways, it helps you. It helps you both ways. So, thank God that you have somebody who will correct you at the right time for your good, because you are saints. And you have come on this earth to establish God's kingdom. That's what you have to do. And if you are the people who are not respected, who are not sensible, who haven't got the dignity, who behave in a cheapish way, how can people accept you? So this heart chakra is to be first looked after. That with your heart, desire that you'll keep your mother pleased. Even if I'm angry with you, don't feel bad about it. That's one of the signs that Sahaja Yoga has not attempted. If I scold you, it is because there's something in you which has to go away and which I must scold, so it will go. So accept it just as a correcting point that is good for you. Some sort of a thorn is within you which has to be taken out by another thorn, and mother has taken it out. Once you start understanding the compassion of your mother, you will not mind. My saying anything to you, my correcting you, or my telling you that this is wrong, because I have to do that. Now, those people who do not have a good heart, clean heart, cannot understand this. They cannot understand this. Very difficult. So you keep your heart clean towards your mother. Whatever I do for you is just a blessing, always a blessing for you. Whatever I do for you is a blessing, remember that. Now, another chakra which is horribly caught up with most of you is your Nabhi chakra, suggesting that you are still very, very materialistic. In small, small things also we are materialistic. It becomes subtler and subtler and subtler. So try to understand that matter is not so important. Matter is just there to please each other, especially to please your mother. It has no other value whatsoever. So you should not try to be materialistic in the sense that, you see, for a little thing you have to do this, for a little thing you have to do that. Nothing is important. If it works out, well and good, and if it doesn't work out, well and good. So, you see, Nabhi chakra is very individualistic, very individualistic. It is everybody's personal thing. If your desire is only up to Lakshmi point, that you want to have more money or you care for little things here and there, without any spiritual value to it, then your Lakshmi tattva at the most might be awakened. But this Lakshmi Tattva has to become Mahalakshmi Tattva. That is for your ascent. And just to get it to that Mahalakshmi Tattva, what you have to do is to use all your material things and your material being in such a way that you please Me. That is very important. So you should not do something that will not please Me. That's very important. Everybody must understand. I want you to understand that when you dress up, also certain things I don't like at all, like disheveled hair, at all. That might be a fashion, whatever you do, but I don't like it. Always must be properly combed, properly done hair. These modern things you should give of disheveled hair, because this is a sign of pakka bhoots coming in. If you have disheveled hair, the bhoots recognize a person and they get into such a person who has disheveled hair. So try to make your hair in a proper, see now Indians how they make their hair. Look at them, they all make their hair properly. Because I have nothing to do with your hair. I am not a hair styling person or anything. But if you do not have your hair properly combed and done, then definitely you are in for trouble. So take heed to these things. Then some people have a habit of being untidily dressed. That's also not a good thing. You have to be tidily dressed. Clean and tidily dressed. Not because it is material, but it is very important that if it is not so, that kind of a material will attract all the badhas into you. You must keep yourself clean and neat, because these badhas should not enter. All these ideas that have come to the West have come from some satanic force. It doesn't look beautiful in any way, it doesn't look good for any spiritual person. We have to change our styles that will be appealing to the Divine and not to the bhoots. We don't want any bhoots to come on us. If you understand this simple fact, then you will start dressing up in a way that may not be modern, may not be ancient, whatever it is neat, clean, spick and span. Otherwise, also if you see to the matter point more and more, no use accumulating 1001 things which are plastic in temperament and nature. You should have few things which have a spiritual value. Not all extraordinary things that we try to have, because they have no spiritual value. So try not to accumulate all these nonsensical things to you. Gradually you will find you will reduce. You go on reducing. You will have simpler lives, better things and spiritual things. Whatever you buy, see the vibrations and then buy. Otherwise just don't buy. Because all kinds of nonsensical bhoots will be in your house and you will be in trouble. So whatever you want to buy, you must see on vibratory awareness. If you cannot understand, ask somebody else, a Sahajogi, to help you out. But don't go on buying things just because you think they are cheap or they are nice or good. So try to buy things which are vibration-wise are all right. And if it is not so, finish it. It's nothing important. I must buy this, I have to go to Bombay to buy this. That's a wrong idea. Now, attention has to be inward all the time. I have seen that our attention is outward. Because of that, what we see outside is not good for vibrations. But if your attention is inside, you will not buy anything that is not good for vibrations. Or you will not own something, you will just throw away. But the attention is outside, and because of that you just don't know how to judge it. Nabi chakra has to be attended to. For that you don't have to think, you have to work it out, see which side of nabi is catching. If the right side is catching, for you sugar is the best. Sugar represents many things. Sugar means your also tongue should be sweet. you should talk sweetly. People think that if you talk sweetly to someone, then people will start thinking that you are good for nothing, or you are absolutely a meek person. You have to be meek. We have to be meek and humble. We must learn how to talk sweetly to each other. And if you do not understand how to speak, then take more sugar, vibrated sugar. That will make your tongue sweeter and sweeter. And your ideas will be sweeter about another person than harsh and criticizing. So for the right-sided people, sugar is suggested. For the left-sided people, salt. Left-sided people should take salt more. And with salt, they can solve many problems, because salt gives them a personality, a composer, by which they can express themselves in a way which is dignified and so not very lethargic. So the speed of your talks or behavior or everything should be in the center. It should not be lethargic, nor should be too quick and fast and hectic. So you will understand Sahaja Yoga is a central point of everything. Everything in the center one should try to bring. Not one extreme to another extreme. If you talk too much and jabber too much and if you are fast, try to reduce your speed by alertly looking at it. You have to be alert. See, my speed is going up. There's no need for me to talk. Let me stop. But those who do not talk at all are also not good. So those who talk or those who do not talk have to understand only one thing, that whatever we talk in the center. Once you understand that, your responses to things would be absolutely central, balanced and beautiful. Now, this is all for me, I can say at this time, because the time is short also for us. We have all enjoyed our stay all over. I think so, you all have been happy all over. And we have worked it out very well. And it has been quite a lesson to all of us and also a very great experience of enjoyment. So not to feel guilty about anything, because feeling guilty, you do not get over it. Feeling guilty is an escape. You must face it. You must face it and see, correct yourself and be one with it. That is a much better way than to just to go on feeling guilty or aggressive. That's not the way, because I said it's not mental. So if you understand these few points on these two chakras, is nabhi and your heart. If you understand these two points clearly, that you must keep it clear. And the expression of that will show in your behavior, in your dress, in your walk, gait, talking and everything outside. But you cannot go from outside inside. Supposing somebody says that already, Mother, I have combed my hair very well, so I am all right. It's not so. Not necessary. Even if you have combed your hair, you might be possessed by a bhoot. But at least there's less chances. So one has to understand it, that it has to be worked out. I think this must be really screwed into your head, that Sahaja Yoga is to be worked out. You cannot just tell yourself, oh, I'm very happy because it pampers your ego, or very unhappy because it is troubling through your superego. I'm not very happy, I'm very happy or I'm very unhappy. That's not the way. You have to be in joy. And these things can work out. You should have patience with yourself, love for yourself and dignity. That you are Sahaja Yogis. Every individual has to work it out for himself, so the whole can be all right. There could be some people who are only worried about others. Worry about yourself and see the good points of others. Not the bad points, but good points of others. And also, if somebody has to tell you that you must organize, go fast and all that, not to feel bad. We have to be like that. We have to be very quick. We have to do so much work in this world. We have no time to waste. We have no time to waste. It has to be very quick and we have to be very prompt and healthy about it. As you know that in this trip you have seen that how much work I've been doing compared to you people. And I'm so much older compared to you people. All right, you can say that, Mother, you're Adi Shakti, it's all right. But I'm your ideal. In any case, if somebody is your ideal, try to become like that person. Try to imbibe those qualities in you. So now I may have to bid farewell to most of you who are going away. I hope I'll be able to see you, but as you know, I have programs and programs and programs. I don't know where I'm going to stay and where I will be. In any case, I'll try to be there. So the program is today. I have a program which I have to go for. You don't have to. Now you are going to Kalwa, where you will have your lunch. I won't be there. In a village way, they are cooking something for you. And then I will be busy with some other programs myself, so I'll go direct to Bombay. Then tomorrow morning, I have a program. You don't have a program. So, I don't know, some of you might have to come. I don't know what is the situation is. In any case, if you have to go out shopping, you can go and do some shopping in Bombay and get things for yourself if you want to do it, those who are going back. And evening time, there's a wedding of Kamakshi and Malcolm. And whatever you want to give collectively, a present to them, whatever you have to do, you can do it tomorrow morning. And then day after tomorrow morning, you have program. 23rd morning, most of you have to go to Delhi. But there are some who are not going to Delhi. Now raise your hands who are not going to Delhi on the 23rd. Warren isn't going?
He is going.
Warren? What is it? You are not going?
Vimal suggested that I may have to go to Pune. I'm just awaiting your decision.
Yeah, all right. So
the rest of the group, 53 people are going on.
All right. So you all are going. Those who are not going, out of them, those who are going to Delhi, not 23rd, but later on, raise your hands.
London and Europe people.
London and Europe people. So this is the second group. Now those who are going to Delhi afterwards, please see that you book your seats. You shouldn't give me headache about this, you see. So you book your seats properly. All of you may not get your reservation. Some of you are going by train. And inform the people in Delhi, yourself, organize it, you see. You can have Perekar and also somebody else, Jaivant, to help you out. That those who are going, these two persons, Perekar and Jaivant, will look after you. You book your seats. Bakre tumi janar ka parat? Acha. So, you book your seats. Then also, somebody must talk to Delhi people and find out, because they want to have you there for about 7 days with them. Now, 26th January, you all should be there. I hope you are all going to be there. 26th morning, they want to take you round to see the parade. I may not be there. 26th evening, I may be there, I don't know. 27th, they are starting the program. So, till the 26th, whatever you have to do, you can finish. And 27th, I am starting my program, but still you will be staying with them, I think. They have got these flats from the 28th. So they have a wrong conception about you. They think you all want bathrooms and things attached, so they got the flats. But I told them that don't get the flats, since firstly they are rather expensive and also they don't want it. They want to go in a bungalow. But I don't know, they also have got conceptions. They think you are too attached to bathrooms, so which is true also. So they think they are obliging us by giving us bathroom attached rooms, you see. So that is why it has happened. Now whatever has happened has happened. Now, for the marriages. We have decided on marriages, on these things. Now who has got the list?
Oh.
has got the least?
In with England, mistakenly is Martine Pichu. She should not be there. She's from Switzerland. But apart from that, that is the full list.
Her marriage is already sort of
then
fixed
that's
up.
No problem.
So I don't know, but it's about 80% fixed. So now this you have given me. But now what I'm trying to say, that who has chosen who, that's not it. So pass on this list, and by the time we are in Delhi, you tell me. The marriages are going to be on the 6th. So there's still time for us to sort it out on the 6th.
I think most of them are relying upon you to make certain suggestions.
No, no, I won't. I'm sorry, sir. Not me, sir. You know the joke? There was a fellow sitting on the fence, and another gentleman went and, going in a car, he asked him, how do you go to such a place? So he just looked at him. He said, not me, sir. I'm not going to tell you. He said, why? He said, the one I told before has punched my nose. Not me, sorry. Will you please decide for yourself? Because decision making is so much there in the ego. So you do it in a proper way. Make your own decisions. You'll stick on to it better. Still that exists. What can we do about it? It exists still. So better, this is the list, you go through it. Make your selections and choices, and don't force on anyone, because again the same question, no sorry. It's absurd the way we do things. Absurd, absolutely absurd. Marriage is not so important that way. Not so important. But this ego comes back, and I have decided, and now I have not. And then this, all nonsense it is. So with that idea that once you are married forever. Take a decision properly. So I bless all of you, all the brides and the bridegrooms, but I think there are more bridegrooms than the brides.
Yes, that's true, Mother.
So I'll have to find out some brides.
A couple, two of them particularly have asked if they could marry Indian ladies at some, not necessarily this time, Mother. There's one from Australia, two from Australia.
Good idea.
They'd like to marry Maharashtra.
That was, yes, we were telling about a boy who's about 39 or something.
Yes, he's one of them.
And no, for him, I found a girl, but she's not a good girl. She's not yet been divorced. So,
okay.
So any other questions you have, please ask me before we start the puja. Good idea. Any other question? If you have really some question, ask. Otherwise we have to finish the puja fast and we have to go away. I have to go to America to really understand why I didn't.
What is it? She's about tickets, Shima. She tell her to see Warren.
Warren?
Yes,
you should see Warren.
Yes.
All right. Brian and Warren. All right. Now I've forgotten again American English. I'm sorry. In America I understand, then I forget it, you see. The English has so many versions. Australian English is different. Every English is different. So I'm sorry I've forgotten the American English. I'll get to it very soon. All right, done?